Hawaiian monk seals are native to the Hawaiian Islands and found nowhere else in the world. They spend most of their time at sea, but come ashore to rest on beaches and care for their pups. Today, they're one of the most endangered species on the planet. Only 1,300 remain. The threats to monk seal survival are numerous and vary across the 1,500-mile island chain.
The four most important ones that we're focused on are entanglement marine debris, the starvation of young animals in the northwestern Hawaiian Islands, fisheries interactions down in the main Hawaiian Islands, and disease. So we've designed very specific tools or techniques to intervene with animals based on whatever the threat is. So for starvation, we can take animals from an area of low survivorship to higher survivorship, so basically a place where there's more food. We have a partnership with the Marine Mammal Center out of Sausalito, who built a $3 million monk seal hospital in Kona. So we can take skinny seals there, fatten them up for a few months, and release them back into the wild. We have an issue with shark predation. And so where Galapagos sharks in the 1990s developed this behavior where they started beaching themselves to take our pups. We can move those young pups just 1 mile away and shark predation doesn't happen. So marine debris entanglement, our teams on the ground can go and they can grab the seals and remove the debris. They can pick it up on the beaches. But NOAA also has a really large marine debris removal program that goes and removes tons and tons of debris every year. Then, of course, there's education outreach with fishermen. There's going in and plucking seals out of the wild that have swallowed a fishing hook, doing surgery on them and releasing them back. So basically, we have a huge arsenal of techniques and tools that we can use to try to save the seals, and we employ them all. Anywhere you are in the world, you can do things to help monk seals, and in terms of your plastic consumption, you know, reduce, reuse, recycle, avoid plastics if you can. Making sure that when you do get rid of your garbage, you don't let it blow out into the ocean or into a river. It's eventually going to get to an ocean and eventually end up in some poor marine animal. We've got a long way to go in terms of conserving them and all of our other species in the spotlight. So the most important thing we need are the people to fill our shoes after we're gone. Get involved early in science and conservation. Get out there and volunteer to get experience on these sorts of things. And then please contact our programs, get involved, and take our jobs. If you come across a seal, stay as far away as you can, admire it from a distance, and let the sleeping seal lie. Please report it to us. We are always interested, no matter what, even if it's a perfectly healthy seal sleeping on the beach, we want to know that it's there as part of our data so that we can track and monitor, because you never know when it might be a seal that we are interested in finding.
Through continued commitment and dedication by NOAA and its partners, we can reverse population trends and increase the chances that this rare monk seal will survive and someday thrive in the warm waters of the Hawaiian Islands.